thank you all for coming out on such a cold night. This is kind of special for me because this is one of this is maybe the second or the third time that I've played in front of live people in the last 2 years, and it's kind of a strange experience, but yet it's a wonderful experience to finally be getting back to live music with live listeners. I've been doing a lot of online stuff, and well, it just doesn't quite cut it for either the audience or the performer, and I'm very happy that you're here. I've got a very interesting program of music to share with you, and we're going to be doing two halves, and the first half are works by three composers who are my friends. And the second half is by composers who are either Latin American or write in a Latin American style. There are also traces of Latin American style in pieces in the first half as well, as I'll explain when we get close. So the first work is by a dear friend of mine, David Finko, who passed last December 27th. And this is my memorial to him. This is the finale from his Sonata Number 4 that was written in 2018 for me. I did the premiere of that just after it was written in this very place. And this last movement, I think, expresses his personality and his character as I knew him. Basically a very gentle and loving man with bursts of Yiddish humor and also occasional emotional outbursts, but basically very beautiful, very modest and searching and very quiet. So I offer this for him to rest in peace.
Thank you.
next piece will be a work by one of our composer emeriti here at Temple, Richard Broadhead. We met many, many years ago, and I always appreciated his music, which is performed very often here on the campus and elsewhere in Philadelphia. And I asked him back in 2010 if he would write me a piece, and I was particularly interested at that point, which I'm always interested in, music that expresses the tremendous variety of ethnic diversity that we have in this country. And he wrote me a tango piece because he loves tango. His wife is also on the dance faculty, or was on the dance faculty, and they are both very fond of tango. So he decided to write me a tango piece. And this tango piece is actually much more than just a tango. It's a sort of a picture. He calls it una carta, which is a letter, or probably the best description would be a postcard, of Buenos Aires. So it is very impressionistic and painting colors in various sections. And then it has a very funky tango, which sometimes there are extra beats in it. It has pizzicato imitations in the left hand, and then all these minor thirds running around in the right hand. And I think it's a really wonderfully fun piece of music, and I hope you agree. Thank you. Casey's watching, a big shout out to Richard. Great piece. Next piece, this is a world premiere. And this is also a piece by a dear friend of mine who is a wonderful jazz pianist who now lives in Switzerland on a beautiful lake. I kind of wish I was there right now. And he's written several piano sonatas. He's up to number 13 at this point. I've recorded two of them, premiered another one, number 10, and this is number 11. He finished this in 2020, just before all the pandemic shutdowns. And it's an interesting form. It actually is in one movement if you look at it in a particular way, or it might be in three or four movements, depending on how else you look at it. You'll notice that it has something like a fast movement and a slow movement, and then a return of the faster material. And then there is another section that closes the piece that actually exists on its own as what he calls a fugue in B major minor. So that piece can be played by itself, and this has a distinctly Latin style. And the rest of it has little tinges of Latin style in various places. So it's a very engaging piece, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I have been. Thank you.
Thank you.
second half of the program is three composers of either African American or Latin American ancestry. The first is Tanya Leon. Tanya Leon is Afro-Cuban. She is around 80 years old, and I believe she just won the Pulitzer Prize last year. I'm not sure for which work. She came to New York City from Havana in the 1960s and became one of the founders of the Harlem Dance Theater and was the music director of that group for many years. And her works are very much dance-oriented. So, and that's certainly the case with this piece, Momento. It was written in 1984. It was her first work for piano of many works for piano. Since then, she's still writing actively, and I find her music really fascinating and very, you'll hear a lot of ethnic elements in the music in terms of both the rhythms and some of the melodic inflections.
Thank you.
next is a composer that I have admired for many, many years and often thought about performing one of his works. His works are not often performed, at least in this country, but there are really is an enormous amount of music to be discovered, and this is the Mexican composer Carlos Chávez. Chávez was born in Mexico City and spent a lot of time in his childhood around indigenous Native American music, and that was a very large influence on his work. He composed some pieces for orchestra using indigenous instruments, particularly percussion instruments. And besides that, his approach to rhythms and his approach to melody is very influenced by that. This was written in 1928. It is dedicated to Aaron Copland, and it was written after his first trip to New York City. He had spent a lot of time in Europe, but not in New York until he was in his later 20s. And you'll certainly hear a lot of Copland influence in the piece right from the very start. The processes in the music, I won't get too much into geeky theory stuff, but the processes in the music, you'll hear a lot of augmentations and diminutions of rhythmic nuggets, and also his melodic approach is very scalar. He writes melodies in scales, up and down, sometimes minimized to the point where it's just alternating between two notes. So the style is very unique, but the form actually is very neoclassical in that it's a sonata in four movements. The first movement is like an introduction. The second movement is the sonata allegro, and even has material returning in, as a recapitulation, a fifth transpose. So it has its bows to the classical period. The third movement is a fugue, and you'll notice that there are a lot of augmentations and inversions going on in the fugue. And the last movement is a quick jazz-like finale.
Thank you.
cool down. Margaret Bonds, African-American composer, wrote two beautiful little pieces. This delightful one is called Tang American, or Troubled Water. The arrangement of Right in the Water is one of my favorites, but these other two pieces are delightful. So I give you Tango American. For coming. If you're interested in more music by African-American composers, I'm doing a all-black composers concert on the 18th at 1867 Sanctuary in New Jersey, and also online on the 27th, and I'll be featuring Nathaniel Dett, which is one of my specialties, and also the Sonata in E minor by Florence Price, which is an absolute masterpiece. You must hear it. It is an amazing work. So you can go to my website, clippererickson.com, and sign up for my mailing list, and would love to see you there. Thank you so much for coming.